Hello students, welcome back to the channel. So in this video we are going to study about the water potential and how it is related with the osmotic potential and pressure potential. And side by side I will try to explain you the terms DPD, osmotic pressure and Tarragon pressure. So before we start the topic, try to understand in the simple way better. See, this is one glass of water. Okay, here water is there. So this water is having maximum energy, and maximum energy of water we are writing by the symbol, this symbol. This is known as water potential. Okay, so this water potential, and we are assuming this value as maximum. So the maximum value we are considering as zero. So this is zero. Same way, this is one bowl of the sugar. Sugar means solute. So we are using this symbol which is known as solute potential. And maximum also we are assuming it zero. So for us, maximum value is zero. I hope this much is clear to you. Ki pure water is having maximum energy as well as pure solute is having maximum energy. Pure water maximum is zero. Pure solute maximum is zero. Now see what will happen when we will make a solution. Now see here, this is one glass of water. Okay, in which I have added 5 spoon of sugar. This is a 5 spoon of sugar is added. So as a result, the water potential value is decreasing to -5. Minus means it is from, because maximum is zero, the decrease will be towards minus. Same way, solute is also -5. Clear, beta? Now see in the second beaker, suppose I am adding 10 spoon of sugar. Here I'm adding 10 spoon of sugar. So I will say water potential is -10. And same with solute potential is also -10. So up till here you are able to understand, when we are increasing the concentration of solute, means concentration of solute increase, then potential value, whether water potential or solute potential, it decrease. I hope this much is clear to you. Now see one thing. This is two solutions. One is your A solution, one is B solution. Now where you are finding sugar is high. So as a result, you can see through diagram, B beaker is having high concentration of sugar. So B beaker is your hypertonic. Okay, and you will say A beaker is your hypotonic. Clear, beta? So depending upon the amount of sugar where it is high, we will say it is hypertonic. And if sugar is low, we will say hypotonic. So first of all, these concepts should be clear. Now see next point. Now see, let us see, this is one beaker, okay, in which I'm keeping a solution, two different solution by keeping a semi-permeable membrane. So this is your semi-permeable membrane. Okay, beta, semi-permeable membrane means a membrane which is only allowing solvent to move. Only water particles will be allowed to move. Solute will not be allowed to move. Now here, I have added 5 spoon of sugar. So let me just draw the circle as a 5 sugar molecules. And here 10. These are your sugar molecules. Obviously, water molecules. Here you can understand this is water molecules. Both are solution now for you. This is also solution. Even this is also solution. So you will say A beaker is hypotonic. And you will say B beaker is hypertonic. And I think so, hypertonic means high concentration of solution. You are saying why hypertonic? Because it is having high concentration of solution. And this side you are saying hypotonic because it is having low concentration of solution. Clear, beta? Now, by seeing this, please tell me where you will find water molecules more. in which beaker you are expecting water molecules will be very high. I hope you can understand through diagram ki A beaker will have high amount of water molecule as compared to the B beaker. So in the A beaker, you will say it is having high concentration of water molecules. And here you will say low concentration of water molecule. Clear, beta? This much is clear. It means here your water potential value is, suppose let us assume it is minus 5. And here your water potential value is minus 10. So you will say here it is having high water potential. And here you will say low water potential. I hope all the terminologies are clear to you. Now you see carefully, the water will move from, water will always move from hypotonic to hypertonic. Means water will move from low concentration of solution to high concentration of solution. Means water will move from its high concentration to its low concentration. Or you can say it moves from high water potential to low water potential. So water movement is in this direction, means water is going from beaker A to beaker B. But you please focus the language carefully. You are saying water is moving from hypotonic solution to hypertonic solution. Or you are saying water is moving from high water potential to low water potential. Up till here, if you see the movement of water is because of the difference in the solute. Difference in the solute is responsible to create the difference in water molecule also. So here, from here, you can understand the water potential is dependent on solute potential. So this much you have understood, I hope so. Okay, here in this open system, water potential value is equal to solute potential. Now let us see what will happen if this system is in the cell. Now let us see, this is a beaker which is having water. Okay, here water molecules are there. So it is pure water is there. And this is your water, pure water. It is having maximum water potential value. And we know maximum is zero. So I hope this much is clear to you. Okay, pure water maximum is zero here. Now we are placing one cell here. This is a cell we are keeping in the water solution. And this is a plant cell. So obviously cell wall, cell membrane will be there. And this is the tonoplast will be there. So tonoplast is enclosing the, this is your cell sap. And when cell sap means it is having water plus mineral. Water plus mineral. So diagram is giving you idea that the cell sap will be hypertonic condition as compared to outside. It will be hypertonic. And outside you will say this is your hypotonic condition. So what is the thing you will observe? You will observe that the water is moving inside. Water movement will be inside the cell. So endoosmosis is going on. Result is endoosmosis will occur. When you place a cell in hypotonic condition, endoosmosis will occur, means water will enter inside the cell. Now see carefully. Now see, try to understand, when we are keeping a cell in the water, water is entering inside. Endoosmosis concept. Now focus please carefully. When the water is entering inside, turgor pressure is built up. Turgor pressure is built up, and this pressure is applied by the content present in the vacuole on the tonoplast. Tonoplast will apply pressure on the cytoplast, and cytoplast will apply pressure on the cell membrane, which is going to apply pressure on cell wall. So this pressure, which is coming from inside to outside, is known as turgor pressure. This is known as turgor pressure. To prevent the cell wall from bursting, cell wall will apply pressure equal to the turgor pressure. And this pressure is known as wall pressure. This is known as wall pressure. And the condition will come when the water will stop entering inside. When the water will stop entering inside, and we will say cell is totally turgid now. Cell is turgid. So now see the conditions carefully. Now see, beta, when I was keeping a cell in a water, so before I was keeping it, let us assume the water potential was minus 5. Solute potential was also minus 5. And there was no pressure, the pressure was 0. This was the condition of a cell before keeping in water. Okay, so this was my flaccid cell. Now slowly, slowly, what is going on? Water is entering inside. The pressure value is increasing. Okay, pressure value is increasing. Solute is not moving, the solute potential will remain as constant, minus 5 only. Pressure is continuously increasing. Please focus the diagram carefully. But solute is not changing. But what we are observing, the water potential value is also increasing. I hope you are able to understand my language carefully. Water potential value is also increasing. So when water enter inside, when water enter inside cell, then what is increasing? Pressure potential value is increasing. Increasing means it is going in the plus direction from zero. Starting from zero, it is going to the plus direction. Even water potential value is also increasing, because slowly, slowly from minus 5, it is coming to minus 4, minus 3, and finally it is reaching to the zero. So we are finding the water potential value is increasing, as well as the pressure potential value is also increasing. And the condition comes when water potential value becomes zero, and we say cell is totally turgid. So from this we can conclude the water potential not only depend upon the solute potential, but it also depend on the pressure potential. So in the closed system, means in the cell, the value of water potential depends upon two more factors, that is solute potential as well as pressure potential. So these are the terms we are using with the potential language. Now let me explain you with the pressure language. Now see, from the video we have understood the water potential value is equal to the solute potential plus pressure potential. Okay, all these are your potentials. Clear, beta? Now I am writing another language. I am saying this is suction pressure, this is osmotic pressure, and this is turgor pressure. See my sign carefully. You know, water potential in solution is always in minus. So suction pressure will always be in positive. You know, solute potential is also in minus, and osmotic pressure is in plus. So we have to just change the sign. As a result, here also we will change the sign, but pressure potential is, turgor pressure is always in positive. Clear, beta? So now see one explanation. Suppose I am saying the water potential of A cell is minus 3, and we are saying for B cell it is minus 5. So you are writing suction pressure value as plus 3, and this is as plus 5. Clear, beta? And you are saying this is your high water potential, and you are saying this is your low water potential. You are saying this is your low suction pressure and this is your high suction pressure. But you very well know that water will move only in one direction, from high water potential to low water potential. So here we have to say water move from low suction pressure to high suction pressure. Is it clear, beta? In your exam, when the questions are asked, my suggestion to all the students is ki please convert the language into the potential language, because we are more comfortable in our potential language in solving the questions. Okay, so whenever they give you the question, whatever language they use it, if they use pressure language, please convert them in potential language. Now, how you will calculate the osmotic pressure value? See with that. If you know, we have already studied that water potential is equal to solute potential, or also known as osmotic potential, plus pressure potential. Okay, so this I'll just write once again. This is known as water potential. This is known as solute potential or osmotic potential. Reason is, this is the difference of the solute is only responsible for osmosis, which is creating difference in the water. It is also known as osmotic potential. And this is known as pressure potential. Now you do one thing, just to understand what is a value. Take one experiment. This is one beaker which is filled with the water. Okay, here water is there. And you keep one thistle funnel. This is an inverted thistle funnel filled with the solution. On the mouth of which you have kept some semi-permeable membrane-like structure, which is filled with the solution. So this is a solution which is present inside it. So if I'm saying this is solution, means its water potential value will be there. So let us assume the water potential value is minus 5. For your calculation, always assume minus 5 or minus 10 and 0. These are the three values you should always assume. Then your calculations become very easy. And outside water value is 0. This you know very well. So as a rule, water should enter inside. This is a rule. Now you don't want water to enter. So what you are doing, you are applying pressure on the solution. And you are applying pressure up till that value. So that's your water potential value. From minus 5, it increases to become minus 4, it goes to minus 3, it goes to minus 2, and it becomes finally 0. Because the moment it becomes 0, inside is 0, outside is 0, water will not enter. Clear? Now? This is the thing, we have to prevent osmosis. We have to prevent osmosis. So pressure which we have applied, this is the pressure which we have applied. Okay, I'm just writing it here. So this pressure which is preventing the osmosis to occur, that is known as osmotic pressure. So I think, so I have to apply pressure of plus 5. I have to apply pressure of plus 5. Why? Because my solute potential was minus 5, which was my water potential value. So if you have understood your osmotic pressure value is plus 5, then you can immediately calculate the solute potential value is minus 5. Is it clear, beta? So till now, what we have understood, water potential is 0 for pure water and it is 0 for turgid condition. Clear, beta? Here studied solute potential value is 0 for pure solute. And pressure potential value is 0 for flaccid condition. And it is going in plus when the endosmosis occur. Same way, solute potential value is going in minus in case of solution. And water potential value is also in minus for solution. So I hope this much is clear to you. Water potential value is minus for solution. Solute potential value is minus for solution. And pressure potential does not have minus up till here. Okay. Though minus, I'll just focus it. Ki minus will be in case of the plasmolyzed condition. It will be minus in case of the plasmolyzed condition. And water potential value will be plus in case of reverse osmosis. In case of reverse osmosis. Reverse osmosis means, in that previous experiment, if we apply pressure more than the osmotic pressure, then I think so water will come out from the solution. Means if I'm applying, I should apply pressure only of plus 5. Understood? I should apply pressure only of plus 5. But if I apply pressure more than plus 5, then obviously water will come out. Water will come out because I have made the value of water potential is in positive. Maximum is zero. Now I'm converting into positive. The water will come out from the solution. So this is the final summary for all the topics. You can just substitute this way also. You can do this way. Water potential is also known as suction pressure or DPD. Okay, what is suction pressure or diffusion pressure deficit? Solute potential is known as osmotic pressure. And pressure potential is known as Stargardt pressure. So I hope all the relations with the potentials and the pressures are clear to you. Thanks for watching.